water, he passes from where? From the Buddha. Oh, you see? Because this is a special, Europe is special to God. What rubbish. Mary died. Muhammad died. Buddha died. Confucius died. All the people who have proclaimed a religion are dead and buried and never came back to life. All. My father died. I will die. You will die. That's the truth. And that is why Easter is so special for us Christians. Because of Jesus. There are people who die, especially if you live in Malta, and maybe in the Philippines, I saw that they are still crucifying people. This week I saw it on television. And they asked one of the elders, they said to him, why are you crucifying people even if the church says no? He told them, we will do what we want to do and do what the church wants us to do. The two are equal. And I go, you see the power of deception? They actually believe that by putting a nail, there was a nail in his hand. Two nails, and he was bleeding. And three people crucified, one in the middle, and two on his side, this week. Not last year, this week in the Philippines it happened. Papanga, it happened, you see? And I saw it on television.
Every year,
yes, even in Malta, they began to do it. They beat him, and he bleeds. Probably in Latin America, where Catholicism is much, it's the same. Chile, Honduras, all these places. Because people believe that by subjecting themselves to this cruel behavior, they will enter heaven. Lies, lies, and lies again. Some people believe that by putting the statue of Mary in their house and having a rosary and praying to her every day, that when they die, they will go to heaven. Lies and lies and lies again. Muslims believe that by praying five times a day, every day, and going to Mecca, they will go to heaven, and fasting a month. Lies and lies and lies again. You don't have to work for salvation. All you need to do is believe. Simple. Believe. The Bible says in John chapter 1, verse 12, to those who receive him, to those who have believed in his name, he has given them the right to become the children of God. Children not born of a human being, but children born by the Spirit. Believe and believe alone. That is why we sang this morning, I believe. What do you believe? I believe that Jesus was a human being. He was born by a virgin, but he was a human being. He wasn't a ghost. That's what Jesus said. Look at him, Thomas. Come, put your hands into my wounds and you will see that I'm a person. Jesus became man. Philippians 2 says what? He left the glory of heaven and he came down as a slave. He identified himself with us. God became man, which was prophesied by the prophet Isaiah in Isaiah 7. Behold, a virgin shall bring forth a child, and his name shall be what? And one of them shall be with us, meaning what? Emmanuel. And he lived among us, and he ate. And that is what John, the apostle, in 1 John, he said, look, that which we have beheld ourselves, that which we have seen, we testify to you, even Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Jesus was not a phantom. He wasn't a ghost. He wasn't a superhuman. He was human like you and like me. He faced temptation. And he was filled with the Holy Spirit. And we are filled with the same Holy Spirit today. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So you see what a privilege we are. He not only conquered death, when you say we believe that he died physically. Do you know what happened when Jesus died? There was a debate by the high priest, if you read Luke, that his disciples will go and steal the body, and they will say that Jesus rose from the dead because he had proclaimed it. He said, I will die. Peter rebuked him. He said, I will die. In fact, because Jesus claimed to be God, Judas betrayed him for money. They couldn't accept it. The same man who raised the dead died. The same man who made the blind see died. They couldn't accept that. So what did they do? They sealed the tomb of Jesus with a Roman seal. The high priest, to prove that the disciples were liars and that Jesus himself was a liar, they sealed the tomb with a stone. Not only did they seal the tomb with a stone, they put two armed guards, 24 hours, 7 days a week, 24/7, we always say it. 24-hour guard there. That is a seal by Caesar, because if the body of Jesus was stolen, Pontius Pilate has his head on the plate. Why? Because Palestine was one of the hottest places in the Roman Empire. And Caesar did not want to have problems. That is why Pontius Pilate washed his hands. Although he could set Jesus free, he washed his hands to keep Rome over Israel. It was a political move, not because of expedience, okay? And the story makes sense. If you read Roman law, you will see that the tomb of Jesus, and these are documented, was sealed by soldiers. And the Bible tells us, on the 10th day, the women came to prepare the body. And the angel said to them, you are looking for the living among the dead. He is not here. He is alive. Go and tell the others. But the witness is there that the Roman soldiers, they saw what happened and they fainted. And the Bible says to us that the same high priest paid the soldiers to keep their lips sealed. They didn't talk. I work with police and I work with people. You know, at the Mass Opening Center, somebody can see someone kill someone. And you say, did you see? No. No, I didn't see. Aha! But they said you were there. Me? No. You
human beings are the same everywhere, you know.
You want me to face the police and give witness? No. I didn't see, I didn't hear, nothing. Are you sure? But there's blood on your face. No, this one, I hit my head against the wall. I wasn't there. You know? But that's how human beings are, you know? The soldier, you were there, you saw it. No. We were not there. We didn't see it. But you know what happened? Jesus revealed himself to the women. Not only that, he revealed himself to the disciples. And the Bible is so clear that one of them, Thomas, did not believe. He said, no way. Until I touch him, until I put my hands through the nails, I won't believe. And then, Jesus had the patience, and he came to him and he said to him, Thomas, put your hands into the wounds. And what did Thomas do? The Bible says, he went on his knees and he said, my Lord and my God, I believe. And Jesus said to him, blessed are those who believe and have not seen. That is us. Have we seen Jesus before?
No.
I have never, like the people at Mars, never. But you preach him, yes? Did you see him? No. But I believe his word, the Bible. Someone said to me, Ahmed, why do you believe? One of those Muslim guys. You say that Jesus is Son of God. I said, you know what? I am not the one who said it. God said it. You wait. Be patient. You will soon die. What, you are 40 years of age? 30 years more? 20 years more? You die. And you go and tell God, I don't believe you. But don't take it on me, please. I believe the Bible. And by believing the Bible, we have life. And life everlasting. But not only do we have life, we have this hope of seeing him again. When we go to heaven, there will be a new earth, the Bible says, and a new heaven, where what God originally planned will be completed. And I will be there. Will you be there?
Yes.
If you cannot say yes, all you have to do is believe.
Amen.
That is the power of Easter. It's not just the processions and the statues. Nowadays, it's a competition of who did the best. It's good, but it's not the best. And someone has said sometimes the good